Hey guys, back with one more video. I wanted to do a quick update on this BIRI Geiger counter sort of thing and explain a mod I made to it. So basically, I did another video on this guy where you can actually see me kind of describing how this thing operates and works and stuff, and you can actually see me testing it with another source. What I actually ended up doing was making the modification I was talking about, which was cutting the window. They're cutting this thicker plastic, a window of it out on front, in front of the Geiger tube, allowing like more particles to flow. But what I ended up doing is, instead of trying to disassemble the unit and put plastic on the inside, I cut the plastic using a hot knife, and then cleared away and deep rided the edges, and then used a little bit of like super glue to glue on some heat shrink tubing that I cut here to make kind of a rectangular shape. And basically what this has done is it's made this thing a lot more sensitive. This chart, even though I wouldn't use it for any real safety purposes, is definitely no longer valid because this thing is a lot more sensitive than it used to be. So lower energy beta particles are allowed to make it into the tube and be detected. But anyway, let me quickly demonstrate. And if you go back to the other one, the other video, and see how fast it's blinking with this sample, you'll be able to tell the difference. So I'm going to go ahead and hit the power switch. You can hear it running. Tick, tick, tick. Yeah, so you can see that there's now a lot more detection events on the same kind of sample here, which is great because I'm not really using this thing for any safety related purposes, just to kind of like quickly detect radioactive objects. Yeah, I would imagine this sucker's going to be super sensitive to anything with radium. In fact, let me go get a radium sample and show you. I'm going to pause this and be right back. Okay, I'm back, and I brought this radium-tipped aircraft switch, which you saw in a previous video. In fact, the one about radioactive antiques. So this is kind of an interesting thing. There's a little glass vial in the end of this toggle switch that contains radium, and it's actually pretty radioactive. So I'm going to go ahead and set this guy down here. Kind of get the tag out of the way. And I'll take the BIRI and put it next to the... Yeah. See that? That's actually, so radium is definitely making this thing sing a bit. So you can definitely tell that it's sensitive to the radium, which is pretty cool. But anyway, so yeah, this guy's with a very simple modification has been made much more sensitive than it was, and the heat shrink tubing here will help keep dust and moisture out of it, and also prevent me from denting the Geiger-Müller tube with change in my pocket. So awesome. Cheers.